The coronavirus pandemic has had a definitive, long-lasting impact on tourism across the world, but particularly so on the European tourism industry, which will see thousands of job losses, closures, and a very long-drawn recovery. Joining us today is Liina Maria Lepik, the Director of Estonian Tourism, Enterprise Estonia. Thank you so much for taking out the time and joining us here today, Liina.
Well, thank you for having me.
I hope you and your loved ones are all safe right now in this health crisis.
Yes, everybody's safe, and thank God in Estonia the virus hasn't hit that harshly. So yes, all my beloved ones and my co-workers and all my team are well and waiting for the normality to begin again.
I think that's very good to hear. So as you said, you know, the crisis. So during this crisis, several nations in Europe and the West have been particularly hard hit by coronavirus. And how has Estonia responded to the crisis? And what is the situation in Estonia currently?
Well, our curve has been quite flat. So I guess our government has been very strict regarding how when to start the lockdown. And this was definitely done in the real time, in the right time. It was in since 13th of March, we had the lockdown, which will end on Monday. So yes, we have the virus on control at the moment and under control. And only 61 elderly people have died because of it, which is, of course, 61 persons too much. But and this is unfortunate that those lives couldn't be saved. But statistics show that in Estonia, there was only less than 2,000 reported cases of coronavirus, and only 40 people are now hospitalized. So we have it under control. But the next steps are taking with the real caution. Regarding to stop the virus from spreading. So step by step, we are entering the normality.
Okay. And as you said, you know, you are entering normality. And I think one thing which has been key to that is that Estonia has one of the highest COVID testing rates per 1,000 people, which a lot of people don't know about, that you have almost 37 per 1,000 people tested, which is way more than, say, US and many other mm-hmm. countries. So do you think this has been key? And how is this going to help you in a faster recovery?
I don't know if it's going to help us regarding the recovery, but our government has well kind of forced us to take the test in that sense that to know where are we at. So it is a matter of knowing where is the crisis situation and how is the virus responding. So this has been our government will to know as much as possible because, well, data is the key to making future decisions. And of course, this is a mindset of Estonia as well. I hope you know that Estonia is the digital society. So e-Estonia is something that is our normality, but other countries still are moving towards it. We like to know stuff. We know, like to have data. We like to be aware of the situation, to be willing to make correct decisions. So I guess the digital society has been very helpful regarding the crisis as well, because Estonians are very law abiding. They, if the government says stay at home, then the Estonians stay at home. They have all the e-services available. We don't need to go to the public offices. I haven't done it for, I don't know, 15 years. So I can do everything digitally, and this has made it so easy. Even teaching our kids, they anyway use the e-services. We have e-schooling system already in place. So adapting the new lockdown situation was very easy for the Estonians. So we didn't need to go outside that much. And of course, low population density helps us as well. In Estonia, there lives only 1.3 million people. And yes, the population density is low, therefore we can walk around, we can go to the nature and see nobody. So this is anyway how Estonians live. Well, in the cities there are a lot more people, but even the city streets are empty and people are in the nature. So we don't have to be locked inside of our apartments. We do our digital stuff in our computers, but we can do that everywhere because even internet is everywhere.
I think one thing which we all have to thank you all for is the advent of video calling, because not many people know that Skype is originally from Estonia. So it would be really hard to work from home with our teams without someone like you all.
Exactly. And this is where we like to think that this all this virtual communication started in that sense. And Skype has done a lot, and also a different kind of Estonian startups like TransferWise and etc. help a lot to stay home and still be able to function in this world.
Exactly. So now just getting to tourism. So, you know, tourism obviously is particularly hard hit, and it's a very important part of the European and the Estonian economy, making up roughly 15% of the GDP. So what is the impact on the tourism industry in Estonia so far?
Well, I guess you can assume what my answer is. The impact is tremendous. The impact was immediate, and the revenues were down to zero, or even in minus in some cases where fees and penalties needed to be paid. Well, January and February were great months. Those were the new all-time records compared to other years, January and February. So this was a great, great time for us to see that everything is functioning and working so well. And then there was the drop. So this is like a good reminder of the beautiful past and now something to re-achieve. So let's take it as a goal. But of course, yes, the immediate stop of the tourism industry has affected our sector quite a lot. As you mentioned, yes, it's up to 15% of our GDP. And considering that the ICT sector, which I mentioned recently as well, that has a great impact for Estonian economy, is around 7% of GDP. So this is a very important part, but tourism is even more. So in March, as the numbers dropped already like 64%, according to the statistic officials. And in the first quarter in tourism sector overall, if globally it dropped 22%, in Europe 19%, then in Estonia it dropped 16%. But that definitely is combined how the virus reacted and when the lockdowns were started. So it did hit us as the rest of the world, and it's hitting us still.
Definitely. And I think, it's this global crisis we all have to go through. But the Estonian government, especially, you know, the Ministry of Foreign Trade and IT, was very fast to respond. And I think there was an initial near-term supplementary budget proposed for immediate relief to the sector. So could you please tell us more about that and some of the provisions you all outlined for the tourism sector?
Yes, for the tourism sector, it was allocated 25 million euros. Of course, this is a tiny amount of money regarding the size of the industry and the impact of the economy. And of course, a lot of fixed costs for hotels and tourism attractions were in trouble paying off because no revenues were there. So the 25 million is nothing, and considering that tourism sector has so many other sectors involving and depending on from the tourism sector, 25 million you cannot save all. You can save only the ones that have the higher fixed costs and who are the first service providers needed to offer the service again when the lockdown is down. So those 25 million were allocated to accommodation, restaurants and catering, also tourism attractions, travel enterprises, and smaller regional micro enterprises offering tourism services like nature and culture and etc. Okay. Of course, cannot help all, and but we are helping quite a lot. And this is of course one-time support, and this is just to survive until the summer period starts. So this is not the cure. This is putting a band-aid on for a short while.
Okay, no, I think you put it very well. Band-aid on for a short while, and we still have to heal and get the actual medicine. So just talking about the actual medicine, and even, you know, the Estonian tourism industry has also been, though supportive of the measures, has voiced that, you know, it needs more to function, to survive, and to weather this storm. So are there any real long-term outlooks being considered by the government so far, or should we wait till things get a little back to normal before we start focusing on that?
As much as I can say now, that I know that measurements to support economy, to kind of give life to the economy again, are being discussed. At the moment, I cannot say what they are. Even I don't know, but I know that tourism is part of it. Of course, it has to be part of it. But those kind of direct the supports as we have given out to this industry now, we cannot proceed with that because this is, well, in long term, it's not sustainable to give out money expecting nothing back. So in Enterprise Estonia and the Estonian Tourist Board, we have also this kind of stimuli supports as well, that changing your business models, you can have support as well. So we believe that that kind of support measures are now reactivating because you have to now change your way of thinking, your way of doing business and the way to approach the customers, the tourists. That this is a restart time and the companies and destinations have to do the restart as well.
Definitely. I think you spoke about innovative business models, but another innovative model in movement, which Estonia and a few other countries have come up with, is the travel bubble concept. So mm-hmm. I think there has been a talk of a certain Baltic travel bubble. So for the purpose mm-hmm. of our viewers and other people in the industry, could you please throw more light on what this is?
Yes, this is the Baltic travel bubble or Baltic Schengen, as they call it as well. The Baltic states, Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania have been, due to historical reasons, been collaborative during the history or the past history quite a lot. So three small countries having had the quite harsh past history. So we have always been very close to the Baltic states, and this time, as our virus is in the same control status or under control as Baltic other states as well, then we feel quite certain that the virus won't be affected opening the borders. So three Baltic states have now declared that starting today, the first needed travel, the most needed travel, work-related and visiting friends and family is now opened. And commercial transportation and tourism will be the next part of it. But we are taking it step by step, just to see how it goes. If everything is safe, then tourism is also opened. And us in the tourist board are very much welcoming that indeed, because although we don't get too many Lithuanian clients, only 3% of the tourists visiting Estonia are from Lithuania, and Latvia is our fourth market. So Latvians come to Estonia, they are in the neighboring country as well. Latvians come very happily, and we are very happy to have them. So having that in place again would be great. But our main market is actually Finland. One third of our tourism comes from Finland, so we consider ourselves as a Finnish southern state. So we're kind of part of the domestic travel as well. So Finns come here very often and are very, very welcomed. But as the virus isn't under control as we would love to have, as we have with the Baltic states, then right now we are still waiting to opening the borders. People working in Finland can move around, but with great caution. And also, let's wait with the tourism. But of course, if the time is right, we are welcoming our neighbors.
I think this is a really good step in the right direction, because now once many countries have started to weather the initial health storm, it's time to start thinking about the economic fallout and the recovery. Mm-hmm. So countries like Estonia, Australia, New Zealand, and China mm-hmm. can provide a model for what travel in the future is going to be like. And talking about how travel is going to recover, the European Union in the last few days has tried coming up with a draft plan to restart tourism, you know, with travel corridors, rigorous mm-hmm. contract tracing and other such measures. So what is your take on the proposal if you've had a chance to go look at it?
Yes, I have had a review on those or a close look on those requirements. Well, those are like not requirements, more like it would be nice to have those. But of course, every country has to follow their own rules and restrictions. And of course, the countries will step by step decide which borders to open. Of course, we as representatives of the tourism sector would love to have the borders open sooner, but of course nobody wants to take the responsibility that the health is in that sense guaranteed. But the requirements, how to travel, how to offer the transportation services and etc., those requirements are also getting in place in Estonia to secure our service providers' ability to offer services in a healthy way. And our sector is definitely very much focused on promoting the safe travel to Estonia. I don't know if you know the ESD campaign that Estonians have done previously, being the coolest, in the end is the ESD like Estonia, the coolest, the modernest, the funniest, you name it. And right now is maybe the good time to use the same logic, but the safest way. So the Estonia is safe and we are working hard on it because this is the new normality and the new standard. Offering the services. So of course, every directive that comes from European side or Estonian side is for us to follow. And as I said, Estonians are very law obedient. So we will, if the law says so, the Estonians will do so.
Definitely. I think, this very smoothly transitioned into my sort of closing questions, which it comes to it. So as you said, the Estonian tourism marketing measures have always worked out. Coolest, and as you said, now it will be safest. So what are the marketing measures Estonia Tourism and EST is envisioning in a post-COVID world?
Mm-hmm. I don't know if you noticed, in Twitter on 14th of March, which was the first day of our lockdown, we had this Visit Estonia tweet. It was Visit Estonia later. Yeah. With the hashtags stay home and stay the fuck home. So this was our way of saying that come later, but right now is the time to stay home. Of course, it got some frightening reactions as well, but the major reactions we got was that this is a responsible way of saying that, yes, you are welcome, but not now. Right now, it's only the only way is to stay home and be safe. So this gotten us a lot of international publicity, and the international cooperation organizations and magazines are always pointing us out as this is the responsible way to do that. So this was one of our marketing messages, and well, we cannot wait to start the Visit Estonia Now campaign as well.
I think that sounds good, and hopefully we'll be a part of it together.
Hopefully.
So if you had one message you could give to the tourism industry today, and the global tourism industry at large, what would it be?
Mm-hmm. Well, as I see it, then the need to discover the world, new destination and different cultures isn't gone anyway. People are still eager to see the world, to experience different cultures. So I don't see that going anywhere. Of course, people are a bit afraid at the moment. It's kind of the same like with the food poisoning. You know that you have to eat, but you don't want to eat because you are afraid. So you start eating bit by bit, a little bit of bread, okay, that stays in, okay, I can try another bite of something else. I guess it's good, kind of the same with the traveling as well, that nobody is eating, I don't know, a hamburger after a stomach flu or something. It's going to take a smaller steps to reach the goal that we all long for, the international travel. So let's start from small steps. And kind of taking away the fear of unknown and the reactions of our fear and the viruses as well. So the tourists will come, that we know for sure. But when and how is the million-dollar question. I guess everybody is now asking and longing for the answer. But to be ready for the tourists and be bolder than ever and trying new approaches, I guess, is the new way of attracting attention. And also, but all of it is still putting the safety and health issues on top of it all, because we care.
Well, I think I absolutely love the analogy of food, and it's going to be one I'm going to use a lot now.
You're welcome too.
Lastly, if you had one message, so as you said, on the 14th of March, your message was that stay home. But if mm-hmm. today you had one message you could give to everyone around the world, and this is not just related to tourism, but the situation at hand, what would it be?
Well, as I said, that would be love to cry out to the world or to shout out to the world that visit Estonia now is something that we can do. Of course we cannot. And when is the time? Don't know. But Estonia is waiting. Estonia is ready because everybody's worth waiting for and coming over. So the normality won't be the same, I guess, as it was in January or February, maybe never again. But people adapt. And better than we actually believe we do. So we have adapted with the flight restrictions from the 9/11. We have adapted industrial revolution and digital revolutions. We are adaptable. We will survive this. And yes, come to Estonia to see how we have survived it.
I think with that, we can bring an end to this interview. Liina has been very kind to, you know, share her wisdom, a roadmap for the future, not only for Estonia, but I think a lot of what you said is going to apply in the larger context, especially about the bread. thank you for your time, Liina. It has been a pleasure.
Thank you for having me. Yes,
I hope we can
lot.
Meet soon in Tallinn over a cup of coffee and a good meal.
Estonian food is fantastic. Please come over.
Definitely. For now, we wish you and your colleagues and the entire tourism industry the very best for the future. Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you. And to you too. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.